18 to verse 26. Matthew 9, 18 to 26. Matthew 9, verse 18 to verse 26. Matthew 9, verses 18 to 26. If you're there, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to speak these things for today. Behold, there came a certain ruler and worshipped him, saying, my daughter is even now dead, but come and lay thy hand upon her, and she shall live. And Jesus arose and followed him, and so did his disciples. And behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. For she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. But Jesus turned him about, and when he saw her, he said, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith hath made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour. And when Jesus came into the ruler's house, and saw the minstrels and the people making a noise, he said unto them, give place, for the maid is not dead, but sleepeth. And they laughed him to scorn. But when the people were put forth, he went in and took her by hand, and the maid arose. And the fame thereof went abroad into all that land. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning, very briefly, the topic of our discussion is what I call a vessel for his use. A vessel for what?
His use.
When we talk about a vessel for his use, the way we look at it is always, okay, this is maybe a pastor, maybe a chorister, maybe a teacher, the formal areas that we are aware of. But remember the story of that man that was born blind? I believe it's in John chapter 5. Is it John chapter 9 now? That the disciples came to Jesus and said, who did sin that this man was born blind? What did Jesus say? He said, no one sinned. He said, but this man was born blind, that the name of the Lord may be glorified in his life.
Amen.
Your life will glorify God.
Amen.
I said, your life will glorify God.
Amen.
A vessel for his use. At that instance that Jesus interacted with him, the situation of that man became a vessel for God to use. Because once this man was transformed, he became a testimony. Somebody here today will become a testimony.
Yeah.
Remember that man, after he had been, his blindness was healed, he had a testimony. When they started their theological discussion, there's no way, if this man were a righteous man, why would he be healing someone on a Sunday? The Lord says in the book of Exodus, chapter this, verse this, the man looked at them and said, you guys are very brilliant. You know the law, you know the prophets, you know everything. Say, but one thing I know. That's what one thing I know.
One thing I know.
He said, one thing I know. See, I know my testimony. I know that once I was blind, but now I see.